యెహోవానీ కృపాతిశయమును నిత్యము కీర్తింతుని నిత్యము కీర్తింతుని యెహోవానీ కృపాతిశయమును నిత్యము కీర్తింతుని నిత్యము కీర్తింతుని
Sisters and brothers, let my prayer come into your presence. Incline your ear to my cry for help, O Lord. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear sisters and brothers, as we participate in this Holy Eucharistic celebration, let us feel sorry for all our sins and ask God's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy on your servants gathered here.
Christ, have mercy on your servants gathered here. We confess we have sinned, thoughts and words and deeds. Lord, have mercy on your servants gathered here.
Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Please take page number 243 from the New Testament. First reading. A reading from the third letter of St. John. Beloved, it is a royal thing that you do when you render any service to the brethren, especially to strangers who have testified to your love before the church. You will do well to send them on their journey as benefit God's service. For they have set out for this sake and have accepted nothing from the heathen. So we ought to support such men that we may be fellow workers in the truth. This is the word of the Lord. Response: Happy the man who fears the Lord. Happy the man who fears the Lord, who takes delight in all his commands. His sons will be powerful on earth. The children of the upright are blessed. Response: Happy the man who fears the Lord. Riches and wealth are in his house. His justice stands firm forever. He is a light in the darkness of the upright. He is generous, merciful, and just. Response: Happy the man who fears the Lord. The good man takes pity and lends. He conducts his affairs with honor. The just man will never waver. He will be remembered forever. Response: Please stand for the acclamation.
Hallelujah, 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 praise God, hallelujah, 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 praise God.
Your precepts, O Lord, are all of them sure. They stand firm forever and ever.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 18, verses 1 to 8, page number 81 of the New Testament. Then Jesus told them a parable about their need to pray always and not to lose heart. He said, "In a certain city there was a judge who neither feared God nor had respect for people. In that city there was a widow who kept coming to him and saying, 'Grant me justice against my opponent.' For a while he refused, but later he said to himself, 'Though I have no fear of God and no respect for anyone, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, I will grant her justice so that she may not wear me out by continually coming.' And the Lord said, 'Listen to what the unjust judge says. And will not God grant justice to his chosen ones who cry to him day and night? Will he delay long in helping them? I tell you, he will quickly grant justice to them. And yet, when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth?" The Gospel of the Lord. My dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, in today's Gospel, Jesus, through the parable of the widow and the unjust judge, teaches us the efficacy of constant and the fervent prayers. As we are Christians, we must constantly pray. It is our duty that we must pray, and it is our identity as Christians that we must be praying every day. And it is our privilege and honor that we must pray. And it is the means of power that we must pray. Which means we should never stop praying in our day-to-day life. It is because of our constant prayers, it is because of our continual praying that God will grant all that we need in our prayer, in our life. That's what in the gospel today also we heard, how the widow, the poor widow, constantly, continually, fervently asked for justice. Here, we need to reflect about two characters. The character of the unjust man, the character of the poor widow. It is said that the unjust man, an unjust judge, is neither fears God nor no regard for his people. And he knows that the people will not respect him, but still he was not bothered about anything, but he was bothered about himself. And he's a rude man, unjust man. He never showed any compassion towards his people, or he never had any fear towards God, and he was living on his own. That is the character of the unjust man. But the other way, the poor widow, who had a great regard for her fellow brethren, and who had a great fear of God, and she has a strong faith in even in the unjust judge, that one day this unjudged will show me a judge, or he will give me a justice because of my continual praying, or because of my fervent asking a petition towards the unjust judge. There's two characters entirely differing, my dear sisters and brothers. Many of us, most of the times, we behave like that of unjust judge. We neither fear God nor regard for people, rather we depend on ourselves. But today, the gospel is clearly telling us we should be praying continually as the poor widow prayed for justice. The lessons that we can learn from this parable is we must be constant in prayer even when our prayers are not answered. Because God has got his own time for us to fulfill all our prayers and all our needs. So what we must do? We must constantly, fervently, persistently ask the Lord for the favors. And secondly, when we pray, justice must be on our side. When we pray, when we put forward our prayers should be a genuine one. And thirdly, the widow prayed on an evil man and got her request granted by a fervent prayers, maybe constant, a pestering request to the just judge. But it is not like that. Our God will hear our prayers. Our God will surely grant. He is eagerly waiting for us to put forward all our prayers. So let us keep in our mind, we need to pray constantly, fervently, and sincerely for the favors that we have in our lives. The widow went alone to pray, but we have an advocate, the Spirit of God, the intercessor, the mediator, that Jesus himself will intercede for us. Jesus himself will act on behalf of us to put forward all our prayers to his Father. And the widow could go to the judge only a certain time, a particular time, to ask for our need to fulfill or to give a judgment. But we have a great God. We can go at any part of the day or any part of the night to put forward and to pray and to ask special favors. We can constantly and continually pray and receive blessings from the Lord. Then finally, widow's constant pleading irritated the church. The word of God says, the gospel today tells us, because he was irritated, because he wanted to wear out we want to remove her from our pestering, the king, the judge, gave her a judgment. But by our prayers, our Lord will be pleased. By our prayers, by our continually asking, God will be pleased and he will be granting all the needs that we want in our lives. So my dear sisters and brothers, let us not stop praying in our day-to-day life. Let us not stop asking favors from the Lord. Let us not stop asking blessings from the Lord. It is our Lord who grants us. It is the Lord who sanctifies us. It is the Lord who protects us by our constant prayers, by our constant petitions. Let us thank the Lord for giving us this beautiful day. Let us continue to pray and receive abundant blessings and abundant graces from the merciful Lord.
Abba Father, let us be yours and yours alone. Set our hearts, our spirits free. Make us, Lord, your own. Through your goodness, Lord, we pray. Bread of our labor and wine to cheer the heart, which will soon be filled for us with the life of your Son. Abba, Father, let us be yours and yours alone. Set our hearts, our spirits free. Make us, Lord, your own.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May God accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of
the
Holy Church.
Let us pray. Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May your voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Fall by your cross and resurrection. You have set us free.
Memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thumab, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Take
of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
grant us peace.
The recipient of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Lord, let me lift up those who are weak and may the bread of my heart always be. Make me a servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today. Even though you were in the form of God, you took the form of a slave. You accepted death, even on the cross, so God humble and meek. Lord, let me lift up those who are weak, and may the prayer of my heart always be. Make me a servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today. Yeah, you fall.
Humble and meek, Lord, let me lift up those who are weak, and may the prayer of my heart always be. Make me a servant, make me a servant, make me a servant today. May I and the crippled blind, bring back the sheep that stray. May I seek the lost and the weak made strong, with justice feed the poor.
Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy own side me.
Suffer me not to be separated from you. From the malignant enemy, defend me.
At the hour of my death, call me. And let me come to you, that with your saints I may praise thee for all eternity. Amen.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where He gives me repose. Near restful waters He leads me. Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is Sunday. Let us go and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please turn to hymn number 842. 842.
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now with